All right, guys, Alan here. It's been a while. Don't worry, I'm okay. So we have recently switched to the RLM version of Neat. Really helps to simplify a lot of things, maintenance-wise. And it works great in Flame, but it doesn't work with Burn at all. So I have a very simple batch setup here. Some color noise and Neat Low Effects version 5. This is the studio version and the latest. It's 5.1 studio. And you can see I have a render node here that's called local. So I'm just going to render that here and that works just fine, right? So you can see I can go into it, no problem. I can interact with it. Okay, so this is a completely working installation of Neat. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to submit it to Burn, and I'm submitting it to Burn on the exact same machine that I'm on. So I set up a separate Burn group. There's no machines in it right now. I'm going to submit to that Burn group. You can see that here. Submitting to this test Burn group. There are no machines in it. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to quit out of Flame. I'm going to assign my Flame to that group. Let it render on my Flame, and then we'll go back in and look at the output. Now I'm doing this so that there's no confusion over machines, installation, license files, which there are none. It's a license variable. Remember that. The RLM version of Neat uses an environment variable, not a license file. And I'll go into that also later, but I just want to show the failure first. So I'm going to submit this to Burn. And oops, really, I'm gonna do this. Hold on, let me clear out the queue. All right, queue's cleared out. So I'm going to enable, I have already enabled, or will, the Burn render node. Now, this has no bearing on anything other than a name. That's it. But I want to make it really clear about what's happening here. Now I'm going to submit it to Burn. Okay, and I'm going to quit Flame. Alright, now we know that 2020.1 has a problem with exiting when you use Neat Video. It holds the process. I've found if you control C, it may just maybe actually kill it. Let's see. Yes, it does. So if you control C on that window, it kills it. If you just close that window, it doesn't kill it. Separate problem. All right, let's take a look at our back burner here. So server groups, this test group, it's empty. Hold on, I have a really tall monitor, so this flash interface stinks. Okay, so I am on Shitterbun. And let me find it. Be nice if this sorted alphabetically. But Backburner Manager is about as good as my machine named Shitterbun. Alright, so there we go. Shitterbun is in that group and it's rendering. It should be a quick render. And that's done, so let's go back into Flare. And let's launch into that project. And let's take a look what we have. That is what we get when you render on Burn with an RLM version of Neat Video. Okay, that's been established. Now, let's look at some causation. Remember, I'm gonna control C here. That properly kills Flame. All right, so how does Neat Video license? when you're using RLM floating license? Well, traditionally, most places have some type of license file. No, not neat. They make you do an environment variable. So what does that look like? It looks like that. I happen to use a specific port because I don't like randomly chosen ports by the vendors. I keep it kind of structured. The at symbol, then an IP address. So as we saw, this works in an interactive flame session just fine. On the same machine with burn, somehow that environment variable is not making it into Neat Video, and I tried experimenting with a bunch of things and I couldn't get it to work. So I'm going to leave it up to Autodesk to deal with that. But some more diagnosis. Let's take a look at the shell here. Okay, I'm running TC shell. If we check in SH, let's make sure the license is there. It is. And let's also check in bash. So in all three of those shells, the license environment variable is there. So I'm not sure why it's being ignored in burn. Okay, there you go. Good times.